Never apologize and never explain. It's a sign of weakness. And from experience, I know this is not true. I disagree with the quote because I believe that it's better to apologize and not have that feeling of not knowing that you know you messed up. And mostly, from my point of view, I think it's guys that do this the most towards women. They think, you know, acting more macho, more manly, they think that makes them more of a man. But yet, if they don't know, or at least some don't know, is that that's what the ladies are looking for an apology. Men need to not be so manly at certain points in the relationship. They need to be more sensitive, not too sensitive, but sensitive. And I'm going to talk about how men believe that to act all macho is the way it's supposed to be and the only way it's supposed to be. And that's what leads to men, you know, treating women bad, beating them, you know. And I believe that's just not right. And in Mexico, there's a lot of this machismo, which is, you know, it's what he says, or I say you're going to do it, if not, you know, there's consequences. And I believe that a lot of that needs to stop, and a lot of that is Mexican related. It's something in the blood, I don't know what it is, but that's not right, that's not okay. And I think, I disagree with the quote. I think it's more of having communication. If you messed up, you know, you apologize. If she messed up, you apologize. It's a two-way street, you both have to do it. And machismo in Mexico, there's a lot of it. I've seen it in my family, and I have a lot of uncles that are like that. And I've even, you know, maybe they look at me, and because I've tried telling them, you know, that's not right, you shouldn't do that. You know, she's my aunt or whatever. And they probably look at me like, you know, you're a youngster, you don't know what you're talking about. But I do it, I see it from experience because of, you know, I'm in a relationship. And at first I was like that, not, you know, beating her or anything like that, that's not right. But just trying to control it, supposedly, you know, it's, you know, what I say goes, this and that, we're gonna go here, we're gonna go there. And she has nothing to say in it, but she, you know, she talked to me, she told me about it, and I saw myself and I saw that I was doing wrong. So you change it. Once I changed it, my relationship got better. You know, it's not more that machismo, it's more of I explain to you, you explain to me, and it's just more communication. And my uncles, I've talked to them, they're older than me, you know, they probably look at me like this young shit because they don't know what he's talking about, but I try to tell them, you know, it's better, you know, just if you messed up, you apologize, she messes up, she's gonna apologize. Treat each other right, you'll have a better relationship. I try to tell them that they're not gonna listen to me, but I try. And just communication is key. You know? That never apologizing and never explaining shows weakness. Disagree with that.
All right, let me start with the things that I thought worked pretty well. I like the sort of interpretation you took of the quote. I think you need to be a little bit smoother about getting to the whole thing about the machismo, because it seemed like that started right away without us getting the transition from the quote to this concept. Once you got on that concept, though, you were very consistent about talking about it. Needed a little bit more structure on those things, because it did feel like it got a bit repetitive and sometimes like you were just going on whatever the next idea was. So I think you need a little bit more planning. I appreciated the fact that you got the notes out of your hand about halfway through the speech, because it really felt like you were just kept looking there for some information, and it's not there. You need to just talk to us. And once you got it out of your hand, I thought that you seemed a lot more natural as a speaker. Your eye contact is not very consistent, but you do look up occasionally. And your facial expressions, it's interesting because sometimes, you know, when you have a reaction to something, you smile, you recognize, you acknowledge other people, and you seem a little bit more engaged. And then you kind of go back to being a little, you know, sort of quiet and, I don't want to say self-involved, but a more intense sort of look. And I think for the time that you're speaking, you might want to be a little bit more, like I said, of that, you know, interactive sort of thing, so that you stay engaged with the audience. And it's not like we're just getting flashes of personality, that you are actually putting personality in the presentation most of the time. The voice, still a little quiet, but I thought you were doing better here, and it felt a little bit more like you were in control of what's going on. The eye contact, like I said, that was probably the least consistent thing on your visual things that you were doing. It just felt sometimes like you would get into a thought and you're looking down or looking just slightly askew, thinking about what you were talking about instead of engaging the audience. And so you'll want to work on that a little bit more. I like the end of the speech. I thought you had a pretty good exit line as well. Thank you. Michael, if you would come get a topic or set of topics and send Vance in. No, that's your souvenir. You get to keep that.